The International Japanese Garden Training Center's mission is to teach the traditional skills and techniques for creating and caring for Japanese gardens, while also imparting the heart and soul of Japanese culture and aesthetics. The center was launched by the Portland Japanese Garden in 2017. It's the first of its kind in the world outside of Japan. The center presents workshops, public lectures, and other educational programs for learners at all levels. Its main program is a three-level, hands-on professional training seminar on Japanese garden arts. Instructors at the seminar include visiting masters from Japan who bring centuries of experience and knowledge.
So in Japanese way, we put the hashi here, itadakimasu.
The seminar's name, Waza to Kokoro, means hands and heart. It reflects the center's practice of combining hands-on learning with cultural practice, visual arts instruction, and classroom lectures for an immersive learning experience in the Japanese garden. The core focus of the seminar is on the use of stone in the tea garden. Curriculum includes preparatory lectures on garden history and aesthetics, with keynote speakers that have included acclaimed designer and author Mark P. Keene.
A sense of space that is drawn into the garden, like that opening that you see in this photograph. When the person is laying out the garden, instead of filling it with many stones and many plants, the whole center part is an empty space. And that emptiness, that open space, that unembroidered space is called ma.
Other core components of the seminar include drawing and design, as well as instruction and practice in the use of traditional tools, bamboo fence construction, and traditional pruning techniques. Teaching Japanese garden techniques outside of the physical context of Japan raises thought-provoking questions about the interpretation of tradition. Two of the key concepts underpinning the center and its seminar are authenticity and adaptation. In other words, to help garden practitioners working outside of Japan find authentic, locally appropriate solutions in design, construction, maintenance, and preservation.
What we realized is that there may be ways within the Western tradition of teaching that would offset, in a way, some of the Japanese methods. So if in Japan, the master gardener expects that the student will, in a sense, steal the knowledge from them by observing quietly and doing as they're told, and being patient and learning humility through a long and arduous training. That could be augmented through the Western technique of giving more direct instruction, answering the questions directly and not requiring the students to try to seek out answers to their questions over a long period of time.
This is the same size, so you should find a small one.
To put in between?
Yeah, to between.
During the hands-on part of the seminar, each morning at the stone yard starts for the participants with tea ceremony. On each of the 4 days, the topic was one of the four principles of the practice of tea: harmony, respect, purity, and tranquility, and how those connect to the work of the gardener.
So if you forget everything about tea ceremony, I'd like you to remember harmony, wa, kei, sei, jaku, the four spirits of tea. So first one is harmony. Harmony, well, I shouldn't say harmony. It's wa, can be translated into harmony, gentleness, peace. So kokoro of harmony, kokoro of gentleness, 心 of peace. What are they, actually? So in what way in the tea ceremony it's reflected, then how you can translate that into the garden work, creating garden.
And on that focused and contemplative note, the participants would go out each morning to the stone yard to design, select materials for, and construct the stone elements of the tea garden.
今すべての技術とか感性とかね、芸術はお茶をもとにして できてるんですね。ですからお茶というものをこう引き出すと、いろんなものがずるずるずるずる上がって、絵とか建築とか庭もそうですけれども、だからお茶がわからないと庭がわからないし、で僕らは、お茶ができない人は庭は作れませんよというふうな教えを受けてますから、だからやっぱりお茶の心、それをマスターするのが大事だし、それはおもてなしであり、尊敬であり、調和でありとか、そういうことが元になっていると思いますね。
Mitsuhashi sensei told me, you can never build a garden better than you are. And that really resonated with me. He said you need to study tea and ikebana and other cultural arts because once they're all linked together and they all have insights that can be applied to the Japanese garden. That pretty much says it to me. And for us to start the day every day with a beautiful tea ceremony to set the tone, not only to understand the art of tea, which was so nicely correlated with the art of the garden, but to start the day with a beautiful, refreshing bowl of tea and gorgeous sweets, it was a chance to engage our senses, which is what this Japanese garden idea is all about. Engage our senses and enter the garden building process with an open, active mind.
The process. Go out to select the stone, and that's the most important thing. And oftentimes, typical workshop doesn't have that component. Usually the materials are given. And here is the assignment, and go and build it. But the reality is the most important and difficult part is go out to the stone yard and select the right materials. They may not have what you want. Then all of a sudden you have to scratch your design to start over. So it's one of those. And so this workshop really begin with, okay, so here's the site and here's the materials. And then which one is the most appropriate? So that's an important step.
It's been a very rich experience on many levels. You know, we've seen everything from theory to practice, and the opportunity to work with a master of Japanese garden art. We've seen many. There are three, four people here that are world class, but to work directly with one of them for three straight days on a project is a rare and special opportunity.
これはね、従来私たち京都の庭師というのは、弟子たちはただ単に師匠の仕事をこう 見て盗めっていうふうにですね、言われてました。だからそんなにこう、師匠は、教えてやらなくてももう弟子は見て盗むもんだからもうそれでいいんだという、そういうこう世界ですね。でもこれからは私は日本でも京都でもそれではダメだと思ってます。で今このインスティテュートでは一生懸命みんな学びやってますね。学ぶ人、そして教えてあげる人、そういった教科書にできないもの、いわゆる暗黙知というものですね、教科書に書いてをテキストブックで書ききれないことを一生懸命こう学び、そして教えてあげるというね、そういう実践の場になっているということで、すごく有意義なことだと思います。
This experience with the seminar was such a rewarding experience because I sawhow culture can come together with gardening techniques to create a more holistic approach to the idea that a garden is not just a design or a style. It's really a piece of nature that belongs very much in an urban lifestyle. And as we get further and further away from nature in our daily lives, that gardens like this can be a kind of refuge, a place to seek tranquility in the chaos of the modern world. And if we can bring the two worlds together to create more gardens and to keep the gardens that do exist as tranquil spaces in urban environments. That's a big accomplishment. And to see the garden masters from Japan come together with American gardeners here, inspire each other and inform each other as to how they could best learn together and grow together, has been tremendously rewarding.